This is the app walkthrough for the Eufy 2K HD resolution wireless battery powered doorbell. This will be broken up into two parts, first being the actual doorbell, which is this portion up here, and then the base station right here, which I just have called Eufy Home Base. So we'll start with the doorbell itself. When you first log into the application, you are greeted with a screen cap of the last thing that it saw. You can press play, which will give you a live feed of your doorbell at this particular time. Once it loads up, there we can see this is the live video feed of up front. And you can see I can double tap to zoom in, and I can double tap one more time to really get in there, and you can see just how clear that image quality is, which is great. Now we're gonna select back for a moment because we wanna talk about the other things that you're seeing here. You could see in the upper left-hand corner there, that is the name of my particular doorbell. I just left it as doorbell. You have a battery indicator there, which is great because, well, it's a battery-powered device. You need to know how much battery power is left. I do wish that they had a percentage somewhere so I would know exactly or roughly how much I had left. You can also see in the upper left-hand corner there that there's a Wi-Fi signal. That means that it is attached to Wi-Fi, which again is also useful to know. We have a bell icon here with some Z's. Selecting that will allow you to snooze either the motion of it or the home base. And then you can select for how long you'd like to snooze, meaning it's not going to capture anything during those times. Here we have a box with a number in it that indicates things that have triggered it and has captured clips of. So if I select that, we are brought to two separate clips for today, saying that it has detected a human because I have it set to just detect humans. And then you can play back your detection. So here we got my mailman coming through and away he goes, and you can see the clip length is 15 seconds. It can vary depending on how long the person stays in frame for the Eufy here. And I do like the fact that it's a very wide angle lens, which lets me see lots of things. So from our clips area, we can download the clip, share the clip, donate the clip, meaning that you'll allow Eufy to use it to help train their algorithm, or we can delete it. The one problem I have with the clips and the recording directly from your live feed is that there is no place within the Eufy app that I have found that will allow you to actually access that library. You have to go through your phone to find that library on your own. I wish they had a simple click that would bring me there, like other competitors, which I won't mention here, but just saying, I've done a lot of reviews of them. You get the idea. They have an album feature. You can select by pressing and holding what you would like to delete. So let's say I don't want this one, but we'll select this one. I can select delete. Okay, and that will remove it. I can also select a particular date. I'm gonna go back, and here you can see human detected, human detected. These are all actions that happened on this date. And if we select, you can kind of tell when it's been in place because there'll be dots. We are going to select home on the bottom here to bring us back. You'll notice that that number now says zero, and that is because we looked at our triggers. We're gonna come up here to the sprocket icon. This will allow us to do some settings for the doorbell itself. Here we can see picture of our doorbell, battery power. We can click here and change the name if we wanted to. We can also select camera on. If I do that, well, camera's gonna be disabled. It's not gonna get any footage. We're gonna cancel. We can turn on or off the LED status light, which is the ring around the actual camera button there. You can turn off auto night vision. I don't see why you would. It does have a pretty good sensor on it for capturing even in low light situations, but night vision is always helpful. So you want to keep that on. Logo and watermark are up to you. I like to have them just so I know what camera is capturing what. Here we have motion detection. I can select this and we can set detection zones, which I have done, and that is done by active zones here, and it's going to put us in this horizontal mode. And we'll let that load up. Here you can see I actually just kind of blanketed everything in front of my house. Here's the beauty of it. We can always edit or delete this, but if we needed to, we can simply edit, and then you would have these drag that you can do from corners. This is, notice there's 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, which allows you to manipulate this. When you first get it, it's actually like an octagon, which is an interesting feature. So just know you can make changes and set it to a specific region. It's a lot more flexible than just a box, which I appreciate. Bring back. We can get notifications for human only or all motion. Obviously, because this is a doorbell and I'm facing a street, I just want to be notified of humans. And then we can set our sensitivity level here from 1 to 5. I currently have it at 4, and it's working pretty good at that level for me. We're going to come back now. and select power management. Here, you can see current battery at 46%. I wish this was somewhere else so that I could see it. You have an option up here for how to optimize battery, and that brings you into a help, which I'm not going to make you sit through. It's showing you use days, total events, false events filtered by AI, and then recorded. So here you can see exactly what it has been doing, which is great. And then for power management, you can select how you'd like the doorbell to function. In one case, you have optimal battery, meaning that it will prioritize saving battery, and it gives you a little description as to what it's going to do. Balanced surveillance, which is currently in beta, or optimal surveillance, which is what I've been doing because I want this to see everything and capture everything. And then you can select customize recording, meaning you can specify the length of time that it will record. So I have some recordings that are 15 seconds, 5 seconds, and then 30 seconds. If I want a specified 20 seconds all the time, this is where you could do that to help save battery. Coming back, we have video quality. WDR enabled, this is turned on by default, but it says if you don't have trouble seeing because of poor backlighting, you should turn this off. Streaming quality, it's set to auto, but we can do low, medium, and high, which is always good. Video encoding format, which is high, which is going to get you that 2K resolution. Just keep in mind, when they're talking about 2K resolution, they are talking about saving it to your phone or the clips that are saved to the base station. You're not actually going to see a live feed of 2K. Streaming to Alexa or a Google smart device. So if you've got a smart device with a screen, you can set it up that your smart screen, should you ask it to, will display whatever this is seeing, which is a nice feature. Coming down, we have audio settings, which will enable audio recording, doorbell audio, so that's for the two-way talk, and then the doorbell ringtone, which is for the ding-dong sound. Coming back, we've got notification. Notify me when the doorbell rings or when there is motion. This is a good time to show you. If I drag this down, here is a notification that a person was at my door at this time, so about an hour ago. So that's the video that I actually showed you. I got a notification for that when it happened right away. This is what happens when you actually click on that event, that push notification that gets sent to you. Either it will go to the related history event, which is that downloaded clip, or you can go right to the live view. So this is nice. I like the fact that they give you the option of which way you want to go with it. And here is the area where you can kind of tell what happens when it gives you that notification. So you've got most efficient, which is get the notification without delay, but it's only text. You can include a thumbnail, which is what we saw before. And then the full effect, which is thumbnail included, blah, 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 blah. All right, but leaving it out in the middle, you'll get what I got, which is fine. Motion alerts, it's set to default, but you can select silent bell change, blah, 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 blah. Got lots of options there, just like ring alerts, default or blah, 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 blah. So I appreciate the fact that there is the option for silent, should I need that, which other vendors need to think about. Indoor chime. So we've got existing doorbell chime. So this is all if you have a chime box. Eufy doorbell chime. So this is if you got one that you're gonna plug into your home base. We have the home base chime because that's what I got with this particular package deal. So home base alerts, I have that turned on. Home base ring, tone volume, I've kind of futzed with that. And then each of these has its own distinct notification sound. I do kind of like the fact that not only do I get the sound on the base station, but when I'm testing it out, I also hear it on the phone. So not only was I hearing that on the phone, the base station downstairs was also making those noises, but I appreciate the fact that you don't have to be sitting in front of the base station to hear those. And then you have your Alexa chime, should you connect this to your Alexa devices. Quick response, I do like quick responses in that you can have quick responses when you're using the doorbell, so I don't want to activate the two-way audio, I just push a quick response, which I'll show you in a moment. But you can actually record your own quick responses, which is great. Here's one that I have set up already, which is called leave package at the door, even though they had one already. This one is in my voice. But if I wanted to, I can say add a new one, and we will call this, hey you kids. continue, and then you have the ability to record a 10 second clip. Now, it is a little finicky in that it requires at least 3 seconds of audio, so if you're a fast talker like myself, you might want to give yourself a momentary pause before you start talking. Hey, you kids, get off my lawn. We can play it.
Hey, you kids, get off my lawn.
So that you get an idea of what audio you're gonna get, and then we can hit save. And what this will do is add it to the quick response menu in the doorbell area itself, which is just fantastic, quite frankly. So now I have two quick responses. You can see I can have up to three. So eventually I will remove this leave your package at the door. Actually, we will remove that one now because they already have a leave your package at the door. And we're gonna go back, because now we've got extra areas, which are mounting guide, share this device, and about this device. All of these are fairly self-explanatory. They are involving the actual mounting instructions, sharing instructions, and if you had any questions about the device. We are going to select back now, because that was our options for the doorbell. What we're gonna do is we're gonna go into the live area for the doorbell so that we can see some of those things that we actually set up a moment ago. Here we have the record feature, which selecting this will record whatever is being seen. We can select this, which is a image gets saved to an album. This is our two-way talk option, so if we select this, anybody who's out there right now is hearing me talk and probably wondering what I was doing. We can turn that off. Here, this is our quick response menu right here. So we can tap on that. These are the pre-built ones.
Excuse me, can I help you? Please leave it at the door. We will be right there.
Hey, you kids, get off my lawn.
Which is awesome. We also have a silent mode, which means you're not hearing the live audio from outside. But if we wanted to turn that off, we just click to mute again. We can either take our phone to automatically have it adjust, or we can select this icon here, which will take up more of our screen. Now here you can see, obviously I will have a video portion, but this gives you an idea just how detailed things can be. So you can see the individual pieces of plant life there, and then double tapping to bring you all the way back. And that is the doorbell portion and everything that we can do with that. Let's go quickly into the Eufy home base and see what we can do there. We select the sprocket icon, which will again bring up our options menu. We can rename. We can see that this is connected via Ethernet. You do have the option, if you wanted to do this via Wi-Fi. I just happen to have an extra port and have it connected via Ethernet. You have time setting, where you can either manually set, you know, current time, 24 hours, it's saying I'm in New York, which is my closest time. Storage will let you see just how much has been recorded. It comes with a 14 gigabytes of onboard storage. You can see I've used 0.25 with all of these motion clips that have been detected. I can clear the storage if I want to wipe everything out, or I can repair if there's a file that is broken, or I can format, which will, again, be another way of removing everything. We have our ringtone setting, so this is where we were before. You can see it did leave me off on the last one that I picked. You also have an alarm setting. There is an alarm feature built into the base station. So you've got different alarm tones. You've got alarm tone 1 or alarm tone 2. But those will not play through here. They only play through the base station. You also have prompt volume, which I have mediumed out, so don't worry about that too much. And then I've got notifications. Switch mode, so these are geofencing, extra things. That is actually more part of the overall Eufy app. You've got paired devices, which will show you anything that is paired to this particular base station. And then about this device, which is the base station. Now, when I was talking about geofencing, things like that, that brings us down here to the bottom. Currently, we are on the devices page. If we come over to events, that's going to show us all events. Next, we have security device that we have connected. Selecting this will allow you to set up defense modes, which is a topic for another discussion, but it's a way to turn protection modes on and off. You can have individual settings for home, away, disarm, geofence based on your location, and then specific scheduling. And all of these are customizable by selecting the sprocket in the corner. If you'd like me to go into more detail about that, just let me know down in the comments section below. Explore, this is kind of going to be where you're going to find all of their products and offerings and if they have any sales going on. We're going to come back one more time to our devices page, because in the upper right hand corner we're going to pay attention to the support. So selecting that will bring you to a help area. You can pick your device. You've got your messages, so if they're pushing out anything to inform you, they'll show up there. Exclamation point right here. Well, this is going to be, hey, do you want to subscribe to a plan? That was new with one of the app pushes that they did. Over here on the left-hand side, hamburger button, which will show you the name of the account and bring you into all of the specifics for the account settings. You've got My Devices, showing you all of your devices. Obviously, they can be found in lots of locations. You have Family and Guests, so if you have shared this device with, if you've shared any devices, you'll be able to find them there. You have your General Settings, which is Device Display Order, so you can rearrange them, which is awesome. Smart Detection, which again, here's the AI, and it's letting you know, hey, I can do this, I can do this, I can do this. It does do very well with human detection. I do not have any experience as of yet with it doing facial detection, and I can't tell if that's just because of the particular products I have don't do facial detection. Works with, here it's gonna tell you, Alexa, Google, and HomeKit. This is gonna be one of the few that I've found that is compatible with HomeKit. And then we have app permissions, where it will show you all of the permissions that it needs to have access to. And then screen pop-up, we'll leave that alone for now. Coming back, additional services. Well, if you want to pay for additional services, here's where you can find out information on that. If you are referring people, they have a referral program. They have a community where you can talk to people, and you have help and about. So that was the side menu, and that was a extended view of the Eufy app for the 2K doorbell, as well as the home base station that comes with the battery-powered doorbell.